download the latest Python version, 64-bit, on Windows, or use any Python installation on Linux. Launch the Python installer and follow the steps. Go into Python installation and launch command line. Then, install the NumPy library. It's mandatory to make the Python bridge work. You can also create a Python virtual environment. It's very useful to create multiple isolated Python installations. Copy the full path of the folder and feed it to venv directly. Now we launch RTMaps. Use check for updates in RTMaps to get the latest Python bridge package. Select the packages you would like to upgrade and apply with the download and install button. Open the Python bridge installation folder to open the documentation. Let's modify the configuration file to use the latest Python interpreter we have just downloaded and installed the Visual Studio Code Editor. Now, let's set up the auto-completion feature. Create and name the file as we see in the documentation. Use the RTMaps folder as Python source for auto-completion. Now load the Python bridge package in RTMaps and put a Python bridge component onto the diagram. Right-click to execute the Open Editor action. This will open the editor you have chosen in the configuration file. This opens the template script. Save it in your working directory. Then, load this Python script in the Python bridge component. This will create inputs and outputs dynamically. Let's edit the source code to write some Python lines. First, add a factor property. We can see that auto-completion is working nicely. Now we have a factor property in our component. Let's use that factor in the code. Get the property and store it into a local variable. Let's print this for fun. Save the diagram. And add some generator to produce data. Then add a data viewer to visualize the generated data. Let's run. We can see 2 printed at every core function in the console. Let's remove the print and actually multiply the output by the factor property. That's it. The output produced is now twice what we receive on the input. Now let's attach the debugger. Select, attach using process ID. The process ID should match the read-only property in the Python bridge component. Let's add a breakpoint then. The execution stops at the breakpoint, and we can then inspect the variables as usual. We can step into, step out or continue. Disconnect the debugger when done. Please also look at the samples provided with the Python bridge installation. You can load, run and look at the code samples. The Python bridge has advanced properties where you will find the death behavior property, as well as others described in the documentation. In the basic configuration, you can select the reading policy, as well as the input behavior to allow or not using empty inputs. Using the matplotlib library, you can plot data, see this sample. If you want to protect your intellectual property, you might want to use Nuitka, the Python compiler. Follow the documentation and install Nuitka via a command line. Next step. You need to copy some Python files and the RTMaps folder as well. Modify the custom import file to put your specific module name inside. Then, compile your code using Nuitka. The command to use is in the documentation. Compilation will take a few minutes, that's a long step. Let's load the Python bridge package and use the executable generated by the Nuitka compiler. Please check, use Nuitka in the properties. And then, select the Nuitka executable. That's it. Your component is ready to run.